Welcome to Paracrew. Today we're going to take a look at LineageOS 15 for the OnePlus One.
So let's boot up the device. Now while it boots up, let me give you guys a heads up on a few bugs that the ROM has at the current phase. So first of all, it lacks camera support, so the camera is disabled within the ROM. Also, currently the ringtones are not playing for some reason, when somebody calls you, you don't hear anything, or when you go to the settings to set a ringtone, you still don't hear anything. Though you can hear people from the in-call UI, there is no problem there. The Wi-Fi support is kind of dodgy at the moment. Like when you connect to a Wi-Fi, it might take a bit to catch signal, and also the signal is probably going to be a little bit weak. Also, the SE Linux policy is currently set to permissive. And finally, Bluetooth is also not working. Okay, so now that it's all booted up, let me tour you around the OS. First of all, let's check out the quick settings panel, which is exactly like Android 7.0, except for the fact that the date and the quick tiles have gone down here. Moving on, let's go to the settings. Now, let's check out the network and internet panel. As you can see over here, you have both your Wi-Fi and the mobile settings under the same panel. Under connected devices, you'll find Bluetooth, Cast, NFC. Let's check out the redesigned battery panel, which looks quite better than Android 7.0 if you ask me. Another settings panel that changed in Android Oreo is the storage panel, which you can see also had a nice overhaul. Under security and location, you can find the Google Play Protect feature and also your system updates. And under the system panel, you'll find the rest of the settings like language and input, date and time, the developer options if you choose to enable them, system updates, and the About Phone, under which we can activate the Android Oreo Easter egg. You may have noticed that I can use both the hardware and software keys. That is another bug of the ROM at its current stage. You can't choose to disable either of them. Moving on to the apps, everything here is pretty much the same as Android 7.0, with the exception of the phone and the contacts app, which I will show you right now. When opening up the phone app, everything looks the same as Android 7.0, but when you try to dial a number, let me show you guys, you get a different in-call UI, which looks more like the Pixel UI. The contacts app now has the Google branding. Don't know if your eye caught it over there. Also, now that your budget launcher has the option to change the icon shape, which is pretty cool. I'll turn it to teardrop. And there you have it. That was pretty much everything new with LineageOS now. This first build for the OnePlus One is really stable if you ask me. The UI is fluid. I haven't noticed any battery drain. And except for those bugs which currently prevent me from using it as a daily driver, the ROM is really stable, and I would advise you to keep an eye on the XDA thread, which I have linked in the description below. I'm excited to make the leap from Android 7.0 to Android Oreo as soon as the LineageOS 15 becomes more stable. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give us a thumbs up below if you liked it, and also make sure to subscribe for more awesome content. I will see you in the next video.